This is a hole that I'm digging for planting a bare root tree. This is 10th of November 2020 and tree will be ready to be planted probably by end of December or early to middle of January. So there is about 2 months worth of time for me to get the soil ready and the hole ready so that as soon as the bare root tree arrives, I can plant it in its new location. So what I have done here is I have dug about foot to foot and a half deep hole, which is about 2 to 2.5 feet in length and about 1.5 to 2 feet in width. This is plenty of space for the bare root tree to get adjusted to the new soil. One thing I have done is after digging the hole out and getting the soil out, I have put some gypsum at the base of the hole, the mound that you see with the white powder, that's gypsum, and this is the native clay soil all around it, and edges of the hole are also sprinkled with gypsum so as to make sure the soil becomes well draining over a period of time. So the next step I'm going to do is amend the native soil with about 20% of cocoa coir, which is this block that I have already pre-soaked and it's ready to be mixed in the native soil, and I'm going to add about 5% of horticultural sand so the clay soil will become well draining with the mixture of cocoa coir and sand, and then I will add about 5 to 10% of compost only on the top layer as needed, since I'm going to put the compost only on the top of the planting hole and not at the base of the hole or in the amended soil. And the reason I think, based on my experience, is the compost gets drained towards the base of the hole, and if you can see here the hole that I had dug, the compost being the lighter material is going to float around in the water every time I water it, when the clay soil is going to hold the water, and then compost is going to slowly settle at the edges and the base of the hole, creating anaerobic activity, and that's not what we want. That probably would make the roots rot. So now the next step is fill back the hole with the native soil, amended only with cocoa coir and sand mix in 3:1 ratio. So the next tree I'm planting is the bare root peach tree. In this particular case, it's a Nemagard rootstock, which is a full rootstock, and it's a Maypride peach bare root tree. So what I'm doing now is digging back some of the soil that I had already backfilled in the hole that was dug and prepared about a month ago, and that makes it much easier once the trees arrived. So the first step is dig out the soil around the hole just enough to accommodate the roots of the bare root tree. So I have dug out the soil from the existing hole for this peach tree, and what I'm going to do next is plant the tree. But before that, in order for roots to not get completely sunken in, since it's a bare root tree, what I have done here is on the soil that I have dug out, I have kept it aside, and then I have created this small dome at the base of the hole, and then the outer opening of the hole is in order to accommodate the root ball, so about the width of the root ball, and the actual hole is wider than that. So now the next step is lay out the tree so as to not submerge the root flare as well as the graft, and I'll show that next. So now that the tree was soaking in water for about a couple of hours and then the roots are completely absorbed and saturated with moisture, what I'm doing next is planting this Maypride peach in its new hole, which I just emptied out with the existing soil. Because it was pre-dug, it was way easy and took only about few minutes. So one thing I'm doing is laying out the tree at the base such that the roots have enough space to spread out, and I'm laying it out on the center dome. One other thing I wanted to point out is this graft point. As you can see here, this graft is vulnerable to our Arizona sun, especially the sunlight till it heals completely. So what I am trying to do is adjust the tree such that the graft is facing away from the direct sunlight as much as possible, and I'm going to cover with the burlap or some cardboard anyway for the first year, so it would not burn the trunk when it's young. So now that I have laid out the tree like that, I'm going to fill back the soil. So this May Pride peach tree is almost getting done. Couple of things to note down. One is I have ensured that the root flare, which is the starting of the first set of feeder roots, so that stays slightly above grade. So if you look here, this particular tree has been planted in this hole, and right where this stick is, that's the grade level. So it's about an inch or two above the grade level, that is the root between the grade and the root flare. And the second thing is, when I laid out the tree and the roots, I did it in such a way that there is always a dome around the roots. That way the trunk doesn't get wet every time I water it, but the roots have ability to get soaked in and the water has ability to drain away from the root ball. Since it's a coco coir mix, it's not going to smother the roots, since the clay and coco coir will create a well-draining mixture. The last step is always try to straighten the trunk right during planting, and as you tamp the soil around it, that's when the trunk can be straightened to ensure the tree is upright as much as possible. There you go. So the tree is now planted, the hole is backfilled, and there is always a dome around the root ball with berm around the soil to retain the water and to drain it away from the root ball. As well as the fact that this is a bare root tree, once I water it for first couple of times, I'm not going to water it till these buds break. So the newly planted peach tree, which is the May Pride peach, as well as the beauty plum, I'm going to prune them so as to make sure the root ball is able to support the initial tree. So the first step in pruning is clean the pruner, very important, so as to not cross-contaminate any bacteria from one tree to the other. And I'm using rubbing alcohol to wipe off any bacteria. So I'm going to prune this peach tree at a lower height. The goal is to bring the height down. And since the initial roots are only establishing this year, what I'm going to do is choose this as the last branch and then cut a quarter inch above this, so somewhere around here. What that will do is these branches will become the initial scaffold branches. So I'm going to do a cut which is called heading cut. So I have taken out significant amount of the tree, but since it's a new tree, that is going to be a good thing for the tree. So as you can see, the tree is almost cut in half compared to what it was before. And since this is a big branch, or the leader, or the main trunk of the tree, what it's going to do is it's going to establish all these branches to bud out this year. The first couple of years, the goal is not to fruit, but to establish the form of the tree. And the other thing to note is, since there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 branches below this cut, some of those will be developed as scaffold branches, and then I will come back in summer to prune a couple of them so as to not crowd the tree. The other thing I'm going to do today is just cut this branch. Since it's a dead branch, this is not going to help the tree in the beginning anyway. And one thing to note is, whenever you cut, make sure there is about a couple of millimeters or quarter of an inch of the cut away from the main trunk. That way the tree would heal better. Just like that, what I've done here is, this is the final scaffold branch I have kept. So when I did the cut here, this is about a quarter inch above the main branch. That way the tree would be able to heal here better. I'm not going to apply any sealing material to it. The tree would naturally heal on its own. So once the Maypride peach is planted, there are three things I wanted to point out to finalize planting of the bare root peach tree here. The first is, after it's pruned, it's been watered heavily for the first couple of times on the same day, and then I will not water it again till the buds break out or the soil becomes completely bone dry. I'll just water it lightly if it's very dry, but otherwise I'll let it wait to get its regular watering once a week in the beginning till early spring, when the leaves start to come out or buds start to show up. The second thing I wanted to point out is the trunk protection. Since the tree is young and it's going to be exposed to the sun, especially in Arizona, for the first couple of years, the bark is very tender. And in order for the trunk not to get burnt and the tree not to die, the easiest way to protect the trunk is with this cardboard paper and gardening tape. What I have done is just wrapped around this cardboard paper loosely, and as you can see, there is plenty of space for the trunk to not get smothered by the covering. And once I wrap this board loosely, then I tie it with the gardening tape and it stays in place. Even if it gets wet here or there, it dries up pretty quickly, and that's the most efficient way to protect the trunk here in Arizona. And the last thing I wanted to point out is the compost and the mulch layer, which is almost 4 inches thick all around the tree but not touching the trunk of the tree. This will help conserve the moisture for the soil as well as build the soil for it to get healthy over a period of time. There you go. So that's how you would plant a bare root peach tree or any other tree.